I'm Starborn. Remember, to be a star, you have to shine your own light, follow your own path, and not worry about the darkness, because that's when stars shine brightest. In fact, we're going to be talking about a lot of light, because if you've been looking on our website, starborninstitute.org, you would already know that the title of tonight's show is Riding High. And the reason why is that on Saturday, we are having a new moon at 28 degrees of Aries. And Aries is the sign of new beginnings. And there are three planets in Aries, and they're trining two other in fire signs. So there's five totally in the dynamic fire signs right now, and that's why you can be riding high as you head towards some sort of new beginning, which is very well aspected. The timing is beautiful right now, because the sun and the moon on Saturday will be at 28 degrees of Aries, and Uranus is also in the sign, and it is the planet of sudden change and the future. It rules rebellion, eccentricity. It also rules freedom, and it rules things that are ahead of their time. So it rules invention and adoption, and it also rules all electronics, so it rules aviation and space travel as well. And so it is basically a planet of surprise and of sudden change. So a new beginning could start right about now, but you could be riding high because that new beginning has so much support. And that is because Jupiter in Leo is trining the three planets in Aries, and Saturn in Sagittarius is also trining those three planets. Saturn is retrograde, and in fact, there is one other retrograde planet this week. Pluto has just gone retrograde in Capricorn. So a new beginning can be getting underway right now, and you can be riding high as you go forward. Why? Because there could be some money involved in a new beginning, and that is because ahead of the three planets in Aries are two planets in Taurus that are pretty dynamic themselves. And it is because Mercury is in Taurus, and so is Mars. Mars is the ruler of Aries, but Mars also rules another sign, Scorpio. And with Mars and Mercury in Taurus, one fixed financial sign, trining Pluto in Capricorn, which is the other ruler of Scorpio, the other fixed financial sign. And since Scorpio rules financing, there is the possibility, as you're beginning some sort of new start right now, which could be taking a trip, it could be a serious course of study like going back to school, it could be something that you just feel lucky about so you want to take a gamble, or it could simply be that you want to start a new job or a new plan, or you have a new goal in mind. And all of that is very well aspected right now. And so as you're contemplating that, it's going to take a little money to get the ball rolling, isn't it? And you may be able to get some sort of loan right now, or increased credit, or you might get some sort of bridge loan that can help you get a new beginning off the ground and finance it until it begins to make some sort of profit or money for you. So there is a profit motive connected with riding high right now, and there is the possibility of getting somebody to help you out financially, which is great. But you still have a couple of things to watch out for if you're riding high right now, and that is because Venus is right ahead of the three planets in Aries and the two in Taurus. Venus is in Gemini now. It has changed signs, and Gemini is a mutable sign which rules transition and communication and change, so that's awfully well aspected. But Venus is being harshly squared exactly today by Neptune in Pisces, and Neptune can sometimes be not only creative but deceptive. And so it can be that there is a possibility of making some sort of change or transition right now, which should go rather smoothly, except for the fact that somebody isn't telling you the whole story about something. So you need to really verify or check your facts right now and not quite believe every rosy story you hear, because part of it won't be true, the part they're leaving out. And Venus in Gemini is being opposed by Saturn in Sagittarius. And remember that Saturn is retrograde. But when Venus is opposed by Saturn or squared by Saturn, that is an indication of betrayal. And so there is the possibility of deception, but also of betrayal right now. And so even if you're riding high, you better be a little bit careful, because there could be a little lie in there somewhere. That, you know, so that's why you need to check your facts. And there could also be somebody who isn't quite sincere and instead can be planning some sort of betrayal. So that's why you do need to be a little bit careful. And as well, there is a planet that is squaring all those beautiful planets in Aries, so that means the new moon is coming under a harsh aspect, and that is because Pluto in Capricorn, which rules authority figures, and remember that Pluto is being trined by the planets in Taurus, so it's pretty strong right now, but it is squaring the Sun, the Moon, and Uranus. It is actually squaring Uranus exactly. And since Pluto stands for authority figures or management or people who make policy and rules and regulations, and they can be very powerful, it is simply a time when if you are trying to get a new beginning off the ground and you don't follow standard operating procedure, somebody could put a stop to your new beginning just like that. And that's why, you know, you could be riding high, but you gotta do it with some caution, and you really have to stick to the rules and regulations right now. So you can't quite fly off in a different direction and just do any old thing. You have to comply with a standard operating procedure right now, particularly if there is some legal steps that you need to take. You gotta take those first before you can get a new beginning underway. So you need to watch that and really proceed with caution, because you could have a great idea or a great plan, or you could want to enter some sort of leadership position, and you could be well qualified for that, but you still have to do things according to whatever the established policy is. And you can't skip steps. Pluto is in Capricorn, and Capricorn rules administration of large government agencies and large corporations. You cannot get around them, and they can be quite challenging right now. And if there is a new beginning that does not meet all legal criteria, it can be stopped cold. And so you better watch out for that, because the good news as well is that yes, Venus is in Gemini, but it is being sextiled by Jupiter in Leo. Well, that's a love planet, and Jupiter is a lucky planet. So love and luck can really flourish right now, because the aspects are so good between those two planets. So they can flourish. In other words, you can be very popular. You can find a transition very easy to do, and that would be great. And you could perhaps buy a lotto ticket and luck out that way. But you still can be doing that in spite of the fact that there can be deception or some kind of betrayal right around the corner, which you do have to watch out for. And that's why it's a very good idea to check your facts and try not to move too fast, because you really are not going to succeed if you skip steps. So try to follow your wonderful new beginning through every single step so that it can really get off the ground and you can ride high. All right, what does this mean to all 12 of the sun signs? Well, Aries, your sign has the new moon in it on Saturday, and the sun is there, and so is Uranus, and they are being very strongly fortified by Jupiter, which is now direct in Leo, and by Saturn in Sagittarius. Saturn is retrograde right now, and so a new beginning some people can be doubting it a little bit, maybe because if you want to make a new beginning, you would have to make sure you're well qualified for it, or else someone might decide that you need a little bit extra training instead, or you need to go get another degree or something like that. But you could certainly have a profit motive in making some sort of new start, and you may think that you can get some good money right now, and I think maybe you could, and even get financing. So this is certainly a time when you can be riding high, Aries. The only thing that can stop you is if you've skipped a few steps. You really have to go back and follow rules and regulations, but I wish you the best of luck, because something new is certainly headed your way, and it could happen in the blink of an eye, and I think you would love it. Okay, what does it mean to a Taurus? Well, Taurus, this is simply a time when I urge you not to be extravagant, but you could be tempted to be extravagant, because remember I said love and luck can flourish right now. But the reason why you have to sort of keep your hands in your pocket right now is because Jupiter in Leo is squaring Mars and Mercury in your own sign. Mars is not happy in your sign. Your sign is ruled by Venus, the planet of love. So since the New York Stock Exchange is ruled by Taurus, there can be upsets in investments right now. And you could decide that you need to sort of plug a hole or pay a bill by spending more money. You're sort of throwing good money after bad right now. And you might be tempted to do that, Taurus. But I urge you not to, because overspending or being too extravagant could get you in deeper debt. And so that is why you have to constrain yourself a little bit. You can be looking for some sort of loan or a bridge loan of some sort, or you can be looking for additional credit, and you might get it. But just remember, whatever you borrow has got to be paid back. So I hope you go gently with that right now, because your long-term prospects, your long-term security is looking real good since Mars and Mercury in your sign are trining Pluto in Capricorn. And so if I were you, I'd fall back on my own financial reserves. That's not as bad as going out and paying a high interest rate to borrow. So try to sort of keep your spending to a minimum right now, Taurus, because yes, you can be riding high. That new moon is right behind your sun sign. So you are planning something new in the background of your life. And it's rather brilliantly lit. Other people can see you involved with that as well. Just watch the budget, okay? All right, what does it mean to a Gemini? Well, Gemini, this is simply a time when things can be going rather easy for you. It's just that you better not believe everything you hear. And that is because, yes, Venus is in your sign and Jupiter in Leo is sextiling it. So love and luck can flourish, Gemini. So you can be lucky and you can be quite charming right now and popular. But not everyone's telling you the truth, because remember, Neptune is squaring that Venus in your sign, and it's doing it exactly today, which means that somebody is telling you what you want to hear, but they sure aren't telling you the whole truth, or they're hiding something from you. And so that is why no matter what somebody says to you, you need to check it and verify it. Check it a couple times, Gemini, you won't be sorry. And then Saturn is opposing Venus in your sign. So even if you are popular and you are making new friends and you are quite charming, someone can be planning one sort of betrayal. And that betrayal could be something that comes a little bit later, but they could be planning it right now. And that is why you too need to be a little bit cautious. Yes, you can be riding high, but I wouldn't trust everybody right now if I were you, Gemini. Sort of stick to what your smaller goals are, because those would be easier to accomplish. And so then you could be successful with them. Good luck. Okay, what does it mean to a Cancer? Well, Cancer, this is simply a time when I think you really need to follow your dream. And that is because Neptune in Pisces is trining your sun sign, which is a very positive aspect. And that's good. You should focus on your own dreams, because the new moon, the sun, and Uranus in Aries are all squaring your sun sign. And they could be overpowering your sun sign right now, which means that somebody else can be riding high. Somebody else can make a new beginning right now. And you could just stand there and watch them, even if you thought it was going to be you. I don't think it will be. And that's why you need to focus on your own dreams, because other people are being super competitive right now. Aries is a competitive sign. In fact, Aries like to be first on everything. It rules the first house of self in a traditional chart. And so they sort of like to speed ahead. And so somebody can be doing that right now, very competitively speeding ahead in a very sudden way. And they can also be rebelling in one way or another, but succeeding at that. And also Pluto in Capricorn, which is squaring that Uranus, is opposing your sun sign, which means that if you have not been highly qualified for something, or you have skipped a few steps, you won't be successful in a new beginning either right now. But you could be in if you follow your dream. Nothing can stop you with that, Cancer. That's why I urge you to go that way. You may have to go behind the scenes to do that, not tell too many people, but you can still be successful. Okay, what does it mean to a Leo? Well, Leo, lucky you. I think you will be riding high, Leo. And the reason why is the new moon, sun, and Uranus in Aries are all trining your sun, and Saturn in Sagittarius is also trining your sun, where you have Jupiter, the planet of goodness, and good cheer, by the way, good humor. And so you can be very popular, and you can certainly be wanting to take a chance on anything right now. And Venus in Gemini is sextiling your sun. And so that simply means that you can make some sort of transition, or you can help someone else make an easy transition right now and have a lot of fun doing it. So love and luck flourish for you, Leo, which is wonderful. The only thing you need to watch out for is the fact that Mars and Mercury in Taurus are squaring your sun, and that means you may be tempted to overspend. Or it can be that your investments can be running into a little bit of trouble. And if you throw good money after bad, you'll simply lose it. So you too have got to keep your hands in your pocket, just like Taurus does, and watch the budget a little bit more closely, because you might lose some money right now simply by overspending and not getting good value. And that's why you need to be a little bit cautious as you do ride high. Okay, what does it mean to a Virgo? Well, Virgo, you've got to keep your mind on business right now, and on health, and on your long-term security, because the strength is building in the earth signs. The new moon is actually in conjunct or 150 degrees away from your sun sign. So I don't know if you're making a new beginning right now or if you're simply planning one. Anybody could be doing that. But actually, with Mars and Mercury, your own ruler in Taurus, trining your sun, there could be a very good financial offer coming your way, and it would be coming rather fast. Or somebody could be offering you a good price for an investment of yours, so you should sell it, as long as you check out all the facts first and the tax situation on it as well. And Pluto in Capricorn is also trining your sun. Pluto is retrograde right now, so there can be a change in the policies of a corporation or a large government agency, and that could affect you. And that is why you need to keep your mind on business right now, Virgo. But lucky Jupiter is in Leo, right behind your sun sign, and it is being so well fortified that you could be very popular behind the scenes. You could even be falling in love right now or taking a nice trip. And so that could take your mind off business, but you really can't afford that. You have got to stick to business, career, and long-term security right now while the stars are with you and supporting you. Okay, what does it mean to a Libra? Well, Libra, this is simply a time when that new moon in Aries, along with the sun and Uranus, are overpowering your sign because they're opposing your sign. And that simply means somebody is going to be riding high right now. Somebody wants to take off and do things all their own way, and they can do that rather suddenly. So you may be finding out that somebody's moving on very abruptly right now. They could be taking a trip, but they could be doing it right away. Or they could be going back to school, or they could simply decide to rebel from whatever they're involved with and go in a completely new direction. They may not ask you to go along though, Libra, and that is because they don't even want to slow down for partnership. They just want to get going. And so it's very fortunate for you that Venus is in Gemini trining your sun. Venus is your own ruler, and so it is beautifully placed. It is supporting you. And so you're going to have an opportunity, Libra, to go in some sort of direction that is familiar to you. It will be you'll have the possibility of just making a transition or helping someone else that's making a transition, or they can even help you solve a problem, and it might be just a short-term solution, but it would work for you, Libra. And you could have the possibility of working in a delightful way with younger people. So you do have all of that to look forward to. So I don't think you're going to miss whoever's taking off, Libra, because you're going to have a chance to do things in a little bit easier way right now without so much competition. You can just be very well liked right now. Lucky you. Okay, what does it mean to a Scorpio? Well, Scorpio, this is a time when you really have to sort of beware of money coming at you. And the reason why is that Mars and Mercury are in Taurus and they are opposing your sun sign. And that simply means that there could be some trouble with an investment, and that might be in the form of higher prices for something. Or if you bought something at a higher price, it could be falling right now, because Mars doesn't operate very well in Taurus, particularly not where the New York Stock Exchange is concerned. So there can be some realignment of investments right now, and you will have to watch that very, very carefully. Or it could just be that taxes are awfully high right now. And yet, with those two planets trining your other ruler, Pluto in Capricorn, if you needed to get some extra financing, that would be possible, Scorpio. And that could be to make a dream come true, because Neptune in Pisces is trining your sun. So there is the possibility that either more money is coming in or going out. You should try to face your financial issues sort of head on right now, but not be extravagant. Jupiter in Leo is squaring your sun, so you could want to overspend or you could want to party, but you have to be a little bit careful about that and stay within your budget. This may not be a good time to invest. And that is because, as I said, the price could be too high, or there could be some element of a swindle. Remember, there is the possibility that people are not telling the whole truth right now, or that a betrayal can be coming up. And that is why you need to be real cautious if you can, but still follow your dream without spending a lot of money if you can possibly do that. Okay, what does it mean to a Sagittarius? Well, Sagittarius, you are sure in the right place to benefit from some glorious new beginning, or from knowing somebody who is sort of riding high right now. And that is because they can be off and running and very concerned with their future. This might benefit you, Sagittarius, because although Saturn is retrograde in your sign, it is being trined by Jupiter in Leo as well, which is direct. And that simply means that you can benefit from the lucky things that are going on with other people, perhaps your friends. And even if you need a little bit more training, you too can take advantage of a new beginning. It might be that someone else is suddenly making a new beginning, but they could leave an opening for you. In other words, if they vacate a position, it would be open, and that may certainly be of benefit to you, Sagittarius. So this is a time when you too can ride high if you sort of aim high right now, and I would do that. But once again, try to check the facts, and there is the element of betrayal going on that you could be involved with. It may be that you had decided to sort of stick to one thing, but then when there is a new opening, you could decide to sort of go in a new direction instead, and that would perhaps throw a few people off. But you do have to make choices right now, Sagittarius, and I hope you are making a choice for a new beginning, because with so many planets in good aspect, this is an ideal time for everyone to think about making a new beginning and getting help with it. And so I think you can succeed at that if you give it a try. Okay, what does it mean to a Capricorn? Well, Capricorn, this is a time when it is you that is insisting that people follow the rules and that they adhere to standard operating procedure, or if there is any discrepancy in any kind of legal dealings, you are going to catch somebody at that, and it is you that could perhaps thwart some sort of new beginning because Pluto in your sign is squaring all the planets in Aries. You would have good reason for that, and it's a little bit better now for people to listen to you and to maybe just to slow down a little bit so that their new beginning can be successful. Because if anybody skips steps right now, they will deeply regret that, and you could be involved in making sure that everything is done correctly right now. And that is why, you know, it's good that Mars and Mercury in Taurus are trining your sun, because there can be some good financial offers coming your way because you are sticking to business. So you could be proving your worth right now. And people with money can be appreciating that. Not everyone will appreciate it, particularly the ones that are in a big hurry, but the people with the money will appreciate that. And so I would say, carry on, Capricorn, you're doing a good job. Okay, what does it mean to an Aquarian? Well, Aquarius, you too have got to keep your hands in your pocket. And that's because there could be very sudden change in your life, Aquarius. And the reason why is that Uranus, your ruler, which is in Aries where the new moon is on Saturday, is being so harshly squared by Pluto in Capricorn, that if somebody insists that you follow all the rules and that you don't skip steps or that you have to be qualified before you can move ahead, so you might need a little bit extra training or education, I hope you're listening, Aquarius, because they could sever ties with you if you don't follow standard operating procedures. You're going to be very popular anyway, though, because Venus in Gemini is trining your sun, and that means you could have the opportunity to make a swift transition or to pick up some part-time work or do something, even take a short trip that could be absolutely delightful. So you do have good things to look forward to, but you still have to listen to the people that say, hey, you've got to follow the rules now. Because if you don't do that, you could not be riding high. And that is why you need to sort of go along with others if you can. Okay, what does it mean to a Pisces? Well, Pisces, the new moon in Aries is right ahead of your sun sign, so you certainly can see the opportunity for a new beginning because it can be lit by the sun and the moon as well as Uranus, which are right ahead of your sun sign. And ahead of that are Mercury and Mars in Taurus, and ahead of them is Venus in Gemini. So actually, Pisces, if you've been sort of going along, enjoying yourself and doing the same old thing, I think that's all about to change. Because Neptune is in your sign, it's being harshly squared by Venus in Gemini, which means that love is not everything that you thought it was, and you're going to have to reassess your companions right now, Pisces, and sort of make sure that everyone is on the same page or telling the truth, and make sure that you're not kidding yourself either. And also, Saturn in Sagittarius is squaring Neptune in your sign, and that means somebody could insist that you get a little better training. And you may have to go back and do that in order to make a new beginning yourself. But the opportunity's there, Pisces. So I think things are going to speed up for you. It's just that if you want to ride high, make sure that you're not skipping any steps right now, because you might get caught. And then you'd have to go back to square one again. So try to proceed cautiously if you can, and check all facts right now. Don't quite believe everything people are telling you unless you can verify it. All right, thanks for tuning in. Remember, you can see the show anytime you want on our website, StarbornInstitute.com.